Look out for that crack.
Are we in a recession right now?
For sure.
Is the sky falling?
Well, it really depends on who you ask. Folks, those and many other questions surrounding the real estate market and the economy today are the questions that we get from our clients daily. So we decided to put together this video to answer some of the biggest fears in real estate that are happening right now. And a lot of these fears are being mongered by content creators that really want to get the clicks and the views without actually sharing any truthful information. So the intent of this video is to dispel some of these myths, tell you what is really going on. And if you stick around until the very end of this video, we will share some of our future predictions for 2022 real estate market right here in Southern Utah. Folks, my name is Nick Rastopchin. This is Michon Rastopchin. We're both real estate agents right here in beautiful St. George. Today, we decided to go on a little hike around Snow Canyon State Park and bring you guys along. We've had some awesome temperature here in Southern Utah. We just broke some record highs. It was like 110 degrees for a period of time, and we had some beautiful thunderstorms. So we decided to take advantage of this incredible weather. So please excuse no suit and tie.
The weather is 70 degrees right now. It's absolutely perfect.
That's pretty rare. What is it, July 28th today?
There's nothing like desert storms. If you haven't experienced it, they are the best. They're my favorite.
Absolutely incredible. The smell of the rain in the desert, you just have to experience it. So Snow Canyon State Park, you could get a daily pass for like 10 bucks if mm-hmm. you're just passing through the area.
It
runs from St. George to, it comes out in Ivins, right? So it's technically Ivins. So it slices this area, and if you don't want to go on a hike, you could just drive through here. There are so many trails that are ADA accessible. You can push a stroller like we are right now. You could take your bike out here or even a wheelchair. But anyway, without further ado, let's dive into the meat and potatoes of this video.
So what's going on with the rates right now?
So the rates are constantly all over the place. And from what we've noticed with our clients, over a period of a real estate transaction, if you're using financing, it takes about 30 days to close typically. And with the rates constantly raising and periodically dropping, it is so important for you to have a lender that is able to lock your rate while you're still shopping. Because if you're able to take advantage of a low rate, just as it happens, like we see these rates change almost daily. And with the Fed coming out with a recent statement, Jerome Powell just stated that we're going to hike the rates by another 75 basis points. So immediately after that statement was issued, all over my social media, I saw real estate professionals, lenders and realtors alike tweeting, Facebooking, Instagramming, even YouTubing all over the place and saying that the sky's falling, you have to buy right now because these rates are gonna get out of control. But what does 75 basis points actually mean to a real consumer? So,
with the Fed raising the rate, what does that mean for mortgages?
That's a great question, because 75 basis points doesn't necessarily translate into a 75 basis point rate jump on mortgages. That's a general rate hike for all the consumer debt. It's gonna affect student loan, it's gonna affect credit card debt, it's gonna affect auto loans. And the reason why this is actually happening, let's talk about the source of this problem, the cause, right? The Fed has been historically slow to respond to the economic turbulations that we've been through. And if you look around, the cost of fuel is up. If we look around at our friends in China, I have one of my former employees and a good friend that's been working from China. He lives in Beijing. And Beijing, Shanghai, a lot of large cities, large provinces in China have been on a complete lockdown. And I was very curious about this subject, and over the stats from 2021, we imported over $540 billion worth of goods from China. And that's just consumer goods, right? So what begins to happen to the value of these goods? In a capitalist society, the prices are controlled by supply versus demand. So if you lock a bunch of people down, you lock them up in houses, and I'm sure you guys have seen the videos from China with people screaming from their windows and protesting these lockdowns, and in a country where protesting is not really a thing. So after all of this is happening, if people are staying in their houses, they're not going to work, they are not manufacturing these consumer goods. Therefore, you have fewer goods to go around. And when they get to the ports are shut down. So once they finally make it through the ports and they get offloaded off the boat, then you have a whole another issue. It's the cost of fuel. So this is fueling our current recession and overall inflation. On top of it, you know, the cost of getting your groceries, the cost of getting anything to your table or anything to the store is substantially higher because gas prices increased by over 50%. And in addition to all of that, we have been aggressively printing money. We have produced, I think, over 45% of all US notes were printed over the last, since like 2020. Mm-hmm. And the Fed's answer to all of that is dialing back on quantitative easing and essentially going into quantitative tightening by raising the rates. As we have seen in the past, the Fed is typically at least 6 months too late to introduce any of these countermeasures in order to control the economy. So the prediction for that alone is not looking super great.
So what does all of this mean for our local real estate here in St. George?
So what's beginning to happen in the real estate market locally and nationwide, consumers are starting to, all of this information, including the Fed rate hikes, without people entirely understanding what's going on, it begins to instill some panic. People start to worry about what's to come. And wherever there's fear, there's opportunity. It's interesting to look at the real estate investors when you think about that. Some investors are licking their chops and they're thinking that there's greater opportunity to come. We're gonna start to see some price reductions. Some people will sell for a substantial discount. We're gonna start to see some real discounts on some of the housing units, and other investors, you know, they're not doing much. They're staying put and they're waiting for bigger things to happen. But in reality, you know, another interesting thing is you see these headlines all over the place, from tech blogs to business news. People are talking about our inventory is up by 50 or 60% in certain counties. Well, 50% of what? Are we talking 50% of our inventory from just 2 weeks ago? Yeah. Or are we talking it's up by 50% from 2019? Because as of this morning in Washington County on our MLS, I think there are about 1,200 active listings. Now, yes, inventory is up substantially. We're talking from, you know, mid-2020 or 2021.
Didn't we get down to like 300 or?
180. We're down to like 180 listings. If we look at single family residential, not including condos and townhomes.
Last year?
So this was just like right before the rates jumped. Our inventory was at about 180 listings for a period of probably, like I would say, almost 12 months. So going back to just maybe January, February of this year, it was that low.
But the last 2 years have just been all over the place. So I feel like the last normal market that we've seen was in 2019.
Well, and define normal. What is normal anymore?
That's true.
So we're starting to see more inventory because all of this information is really creating a ton of uncertainty, and folks are starting to go back and forth. And then another thing that happened is, you know, the quantitative tightening is really helping, because back when people were able to buy houses for, you know, 2.5%, 2.8%, all those things were possible. And back then, the news sources were telling you that unless you got cash, you're not going to be able to buy. Now they're telling you, don't buy because you can't afford it. So back in 2021, 2020, if you wanted to purchase a house, the discussion was that you had to offer substantially over asking unless you had 50 to 100 grand to bring to a table. In most markets like Southern Utah, California, Washington, all of the really hot markets, the deals were happening substantially over asking price. And if you were to go back and look at the news stories from the same sources, they would tell you that the bidding wars are happening. And unless you've got cash, you know, that 2.5% financing, if that's all you got, you were not able to make a deal happen back then either. So now so many consumers, if you look at like 2.5 to, I think as of this morning, interest rates are around 6.2%, somewhere right around there. Mm-hmm. Average consumer lost around 200 grand from their approval ability. So the number one rule that we don't do in real estate as real estate agents is you don't take somebody out and start shopping unless you really know what they're qualified for. So the reason,
you'll give your hopes up.
You don't want to waste their time, you don't want to waste your time. So if somebody was shopping in the 650s when the rates were lower and now their new normal is 450s, mm-hmm. you're looking at totally different kinds of properties. So
let's talk about, is it a good time to buy a house right now? And maybe the importance of actually getting your rate locked.
And that's a huge point, because here's the deal. If you have to buy a house, don't scratch yourself. Do not buy something that you cannot afford. But especially if you're renting right now, what's happening with rents is so many corporations are pension funds, hedge funds, and big corporations, they're increasing their real estate holdings. We have not seen how that's affecting the rental market yet, because a lot of these acquisitions haven't been put in place as rental units yet. But the future of rents is not looking very bright. When you have a corporation that controls a large sector of inventory, that corporation is going to be able to essentially dictate the rents. And folks are getting upset with landlords right now, but they have to understand that in this market where everything, literally everything, is costing more, there's only one way for these rents to go, and that's up. So if you're able to reasonably afford a home, don't stretch yourself, don't put yourself over your budget. You know, if you're able to afford a home without putting yourself in a hole, you know, it's going to lock you in for a 30-day rate for a predictable mortgage payment, versus if you're renting right now, that rent that you're paying today is not guaranteed to be the same rent tomorrow, because as the markets change, the cost of real estate changes, the operational costs change.
Rents just keep going up and up and up.
And from what we're seeing with the way the Fed's been handling this inflation, they've been talking about this being transitory. They've been talking about this being not real, to finally now, as of yesterday, admitting it and saying, man, we really have to do something about this. So we're about 6 months too late. And what will likely happen is they will continue to raise the rates for a while until they just completely wreck some things. And it is surely a recipe for a financial disaster for a lot of folks. But if you're buying within your means and you're buying something that you could truly afford and you could lock in your rate, I would say for sure do it. And look at it this way. If this continues and we continue to see these rate hikes, eventually they're going to push this so far that they're going to have to start dialing back on these rates. Will we see 2.5 again? Probably not.
Yeah.
I would say that 2.5 to 3% rates were not sustainable, and that's partly what created this issue. Now, as we discussed inventory shortages, and we discussed all these other issues affecting our current state of economy, real estate still did contribute to the problem, and I don't think that 2.5 or 3% rates are sustainable. What we have right now is likely to be closer to reality. However, the Fed will likely push this issue further along and raise the rates more and more until it's inevitable where they have to turn back and start lowering the rates again. It's getting a little toasty.
Yeah, I'm like, oh, we have to turn around.
Make sure you bring lots of water on these hikes.
Like, it's only 70, but the sun came out and I'm like, oh.
Sun came out, it got nice and toasty. Folks, so if you're thinking about buying this market, it could still be a good idea. And with the progression of the rates and the direction that the economy is headed, there's a good chance that if you buy now and you lock in your rate, lock it in with a lender that could do it while you're still shopping.
I mean, there's different rate locks you can do, 30, 60, 90 days. You can even do up to a year with doing new construction.
Doing new construction, you're building right now.
There's a lot of options. I know there's a lot of doom and gloom everywhere you look right now, but, you know, what does that necessarily...
Yeah, and, you know, look at it this way. Even a 5 or 6% rate still buys you a lot of certainty knowing that your landlord, whether it's a corporation or a private landlord, that's forced to deal with the economic circumstances of the future, the near future. You know, who knows when all of this is going to improve. It is a lot more certainty to own a piece of real estate versus renting it. And if you can't afford to do it, well, then that could be your only option right now.
Because rents just seem to keep going up substantially every single year that you renew your lease.
Well, and the reason that happens is because when investors buy, you know, if the split on that margin, the capitalization rate is low when they buy to begin with, and then their expenses go up, their property management fees go up, and landlords also depend on that income. So as it becomes more expensive to live in the U.S., to live in southern Utah, to live in St. George, the landlords also depend on that income. So naturally, your rent is going to continue to go up.
So do you think the market's going to crash?
You know, that's another solid reason why so many people are sitting on the sidelines right now, because they're waiting for a crash, right? They're waiting for better deals to come. And let's talk about the components that are necessary for a real estate crash to happen. So last crash that took place in 2008, we had lots of inventory. The builders were overbuilding. We had lots of credit that wasn't backed by incomes. Literally anybody could get a loan. And
or they were getting, what is it called?
The stated income loans?
No, the perceived income? Or
perceived income loans. Yeah. You could literally walk into...
like a new business and say, I'm projecting to make this much this year.
And there was zero due process. There was zero verification. Somebody could say that they started, I don't know, a lawn mowing business or business collecting butterflies, and they're projecting to make a few million dollars this year. And they would walk out and, there's a bunny right there.
Cute.
They would walk out and get a few notes on a couple of properties if they wanted to. So lending has changed a lot.
I mean, that might be a little dramatic, but listen.
What are you doing?
Oh, I don't know,
we're shooting a video. What happened?
I thought someone was camping in there. It was for the water.
So the lenders now are a lot more careful with who and how they lend money out to. There's a lot more regulation in the finance sector. So people are not just getting crazy mortgages for the properties they can't afford. We're not seeing massive waves of delinquencies on notes. And on top of that, given the recent madness of the real estate market, people have so much equity in their homes that if somebody was facing a foreclosure right now, they could just sell out of it, because over the last 2 years, most properties appreciated by nearly 45%.
We haven't seen any foreclosures, no short sales, so.
Well, it wouldn't make sense, because a short sale could take up to a year, and it was absolutely horrible when people were doing that in 2008.
Yeah.
And now, with the current state of the market, you know, with things still selling really fast in southern Utah, anything that's priced well, anything that doesn't have any projects, anything that's like a turnkey property, the deals are beginning to happen in a more fair way, but everything is still selling in 14 to 30 days, which is a much healthier environment for a buyer. You don't have to commit your earnest money. You don't have to waive the appraisal. You don't have to waive the due diligence. You could actually spend your time and look around. So I would say what's happening.
Would you say we're in like a buyer's market right now?
Not quite yet. No. In order for us
to
be.
We were definitely in a seller's market for a long time.
We're in a seller's market by a long shot for a long time. But right now things have stabilized. So another important aspect of a housing market crash, as we talked earlier in this video, supply versus demand. In 2008, we had just a ton of supply that was sitting on the market. It wasn't moving. And based on the current US averages, I don't really know where these numbers come from. And I don't even know with the current border situation, if you could even tell what is the total population in this country, because people can just come and go as they please. But if we choose for these numbers to be true, we're somewhere to the tune of 5 to 10 million housing units shortage. So the demand is there. And what we're seeing in our current market, and this is a little bit of a crystal ball prediction as to what's to happen in the future. People that are looking at these high interest rates, people that would normally, keeping up with the Joneses is a big part of the local culture in terms of cars, housing. People are very driven. They like to get new stuff. They like to upgrade every now and again. And what that means in the housing market is that every couple of years, maybe 3 to 5 years, young families would have the need to upgrade to a new house. But if the rates are higher and you have that home that you're living in right now financed at 2.5%, there's no way you're selling it. So, and probably if you're not selling it, you're less likely to have the ability to upgrade to a new house. So that takes away inventory. We have seen some builders that have pulled back. So we've seen the builders do two things. There's one local builder that's giving incentives to the buyers. They will pay up to 2% towards their closing costs. And they're giving greater incentives to the real estate agents. And their product is actually pretty good. But I'm not gonna analyze their financial situation, but my guess is they have to liquidate some inventory. So after that happens, and after these things settle down, I don't think that we're going to see any spikes in our inventory. And our inventory right now is still at about 50% or less of what we saw that was last that we've seen our house or our housing market as normal. Now what's happening to other builders is they're starting to pull back on some of their projects. Some of the projects that were all the way up to framing, they're pulling framers off the job sites and they're saying, hey, cost of new construction is so high because again, cost of fuel is high, cost of labor is high, cost of supplies is high, and also deliveries are uncertain. So they're starting to say, we're flush with cash. We don't really need to finish building these next 50 to 100 homes. We're just gonna sit tight and see what happens to the housing market. So now we're losing that inventory that was already in pre-construction status that is not even being built. Sorry guys, if you hear me panting.
I'm like, I'm dying.
I've been watching Michon push this stroller uphill and it made me real tired. It's crazy how the sun coming out, it's just entirely changed how it feels outside. Still feels really nice, but we've hiked for, about a mile?
I don't even know.
It got considerably hotter. Anyway, if any of you are worried about the housing market crashing, whether you own or if you're looking to own maybe another property, maybe a second home, or maybe you're renting and you're looking to purchase your first home, the fear of a housing crash should be pretty minimal. And there are many, many other credible experts that are way smarter and have way more data points than I do that tend to agree with this point, that we just simply don't have enough inventory for the crash to happen. And the folks that have these housing units, of course, in any market, you're gonna see some people that are going to lose because of financial mistakes that they have made. Never ever overcommit to something, because if you buy the dream house that you can't afford, you'll remember very quickly how important it is for you to be able to actually afford food.
And well, just this inflation, don't stretch yourself.
Like, absolutely.
Make sure that you've got some cushion for, I don't know, if
fuel prices
go up more, or food, or just always, yeah, for emergencies, just don't stretch yourself. Make sure that you're comfortable. And
I don't remember what the exact number is, but majority of the U.S. consumers, if any expenditure over $400 came up,
hey, good morning.
How you doing? Most people would not be able to afford it without getting in debt. So don't stretch yourself. If you're thinking about buying a home right now, I'll tell you this much, it is much better as far as your experience goes, as far as your options go, to do it in 2022 versus doing it just 6 months ago. Even though the rates were lower, I have personally talked people out of buying because of how crazy they had to offer.
Mm-hmm.
People were offering on properties that were not worth $500 per square foot, nearly $500 per square foot. So there were some very irrational purchases that were made over that period of time. And now as a buyer, you actually have some time to think about it and make things happen. Now as a seller, our inventory is still pretty low.
Well, yeah. The price per square foot's gone down, so you're getting more home for your money right now. So,
and most sellers that are looking to sell right now, they're still in a really good position. So the sellers that are selling this market, as long as your property is priced reasonably for its condition, meaning that if you have some outstanding repairs or major projects, you can still sell your home as is. It'll sell a lot faster if there's no issues with that property, because consumers are a lot more sentimental towards spendings and they're stretching themselves with these higher mortgage rates, and often they just max out their monthly budgets, you know, within the tolerances they could spend, so they have fewer dollars to bring to the table to finish some unfinished projects. However, there's still investors, and you know, wherever there's fear, there's opportunity. So you could still sell your home to an investor. You just have to price it within reason. And most listings that are priced well still sell in about a 14 to 30 day period. Folks, if you're thinking about buying, selling, or investing in Southern Utah, reach out to us, drop us a line, tell us two or three things about the things that you love or hate, and we will be sure to pair you with the right neighborhood if you're looking to buy. And if you're selling, you definitely need a qualified professional in your corner that knows the market, that knows the area, and knows what's happening in the real estate world right now. We are wrapping up our hike. It's getting kind of hot. Thank you all so much for tuning in and checking out this video. Let us know what you think about this stroller cam setup. Should we continue to make these videos? If you found this video useful, share it with a friend. Do all that good stuff. Like, follow, subscribe. Give it a thumbs up. Peace. Towards spendings, people are less likely to buy stuff with It survived.
No, it was scratched.
How did that happen?
Stupid bridge. I was... Is this video like an hour?